हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू चैप्टर व्हिच इज लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड देयर सराउंडिंग। लेट गेट स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट लिविंग एंड नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स एंड एन एनवायरमेंट, हैबिटेट, टाइप्स ऑफ हैबिटेट, एडेप्टेशन, एक्लिमेटाइजेशन। As you know, all living beings living in a particular surrounding that includes plants, animals, land, air, water, sky, and many other living and non-living things. All these things affect the life of living beings. Anything that surrounds and affects the life of an organism, that is called as environment. So, in our environment, living things and non-living things are present. So living things are the things that are alive. They need food, water and air for their survival. They have ability to reproduce, ability to grow and change the stimulus towards response. Example of living things are plants and animals. Now, non-living things. Non-living things are the things that were not alive. They do not need any kind of food, water and air. They do not have an ability to grow and reproduce and change towards stimulus. Example of non-living things are like table, chair, you can see like blackboard. These all are the examples of non-living things. Here in this slide, you are able to see living things and non-living things very minutely. Now, there is a few characteristics which is shown by the organism who are live or who are living things. The first character is living things need air, water and food. They are able to grow. They move from one place to another place. Their ability to respire, they have ability to excrete, they have ability to reproduce, they can respond to stimulus, they have a definite lifespan. These are the few characteristics of the living things. Here also in this slide I am showing you the characteristic in a diagrammatic form. Here is the difference between living and non-living things. As you know, the living things need food, air and water, but non-living things do not need any kind of food, air and water. Living things grow, but non-living things do not grow. Living things move from one place to another place, but non-living things do not move from one place to another place. Living things are sensitive towards environment and change towards the response. But non-living things are not sensitive. They do not respond to the change around them. These are the few differences of the living things and non-living things. Now come to the one by one. I'm going to discuss about the features of the living things. First one is nutrition. What is nutrition? A nutrition is a process by which animal obtains food and utilizes it for all activities called as nutrition. Every organism needs energy to grow and to their body function. So they need food, water to live. Green plants make their own food with the help of process which is called as photosynthesis. They prepare their food with the help of air and water in presence of sunlight. But animals are not able to prepare their food. They depend on plant directly or indirectly to obtain their food from plant. All living organisms grow and exhibit growth in different way. All organisms increase in a size with their ages. This is known as growth. Growth is one of the basic feature of all living things. Some living things grow only for some period of their life, and some grow continuously during the whole period of their life. Like a baby grow into an adult. If you see in animals like fish, hand, turtle, birds, all lay eggs. The young ones hatches out of the egg and in a few weeks grow into adults. So animals do not grow after a certain age, but the plant grow throughout their life. A seed grow into baby plant and the plant grow into a big tree. So the growth is a specific basic feature of the living beings. Now move to the respiration. Respiration is necessary for all living organisms. It is through respiration that the body finally obtains energy from the food intake. The food inside the body is broken down into energy, the carbon dioxide gas and water vapor. This process is called as respiration. Some animals may have different mechanism for the exchange of gases, which is the part of the respiration process. For example, earthworm breathe through the skin. The fish have gills for using oxygen dissolved in water. In human, we respire by breathing in oxygen and breathing out carbon dioxide. In plants, the process of respiration take place through the leaf. The leaves take in air, which is carbon dioxide, through a tiny pores in them, which is called as stomata, and use the oxygen, carbon dioxide. And they give out oxygen to air. So like this, plant respire. As you see, the fish in this diagram use a gills for the respiration, and in human beings we are using our lungs for respiration. Now response to stimulus. What is this response to stimulus? If you sit on a drawing pen, you jump up quickly. A pringing up on your bottom is called as stimulus. Your jumping is called as response. A change in an immediate environment that influences an activity in an organism is called stimulus. And the organisms react to the stimulus is called response. Living things respond to different kinds of stimuli. The main ones are touch, chemicals, heat, light and sound. Plants do not respond to certain stimuli, but such slowly that animal. The response by growing into a particular direction. For example, if you see the plants growing towards light, there are a few plants which respond quickly to touch like animal do. For example, the leaf of touch me not plant. Close up when you touch it. In this figure, you are able to see if you touch the touch me not plant, the leaves are closed. In after figure, you are able to see this one. The touch me not plant close their leaf after touching. Now come to the excretion. All living things take food. Not all the foods that is eaten is really used. Only a part of it utilized by the body. Unused or remaining food become waste and need to excrete it. Our body also produce some waste like urea in our living processes. Living organisms get rid of all these waste materials, and the process is called as respiration, excretion. For example, the urea is produced in the liver as an excretory waste by the animals, and it is removed as a urine. Now come to the reproduction. All living organisms give rise to a new organism of their own kind by the process called as reproduction. The mode of reproduction may be different in different animals and plants. Some animals produce their young ones through egg. Someone gives to young ones. Plants produce seed which germinate into a new plant. Some plants also produce through parts other than seed. For example, a part of potato with a burr grow into a new plant. As you see in this diagram. Now move to the next one, which is movement. Animals move from one place to another place and also show other body movements. Plants are generally do not move from one place to another place, but they still show movement. They move with their stalks and their leaves. Their roots grow and move into soil. The stem move towards light. For example, sunflower moves its face from west to east with the sun. Plants also show other kind of movement, like opening and closing of flower buds. This is also included in a movement of plants. Now, we will discuss about the environment. Environment can be defined as a sum total of living and non-living elements and their effect which influenced human life. An organism's environment consists of two parts, biotic environment and abiotic environment. In a biotic environment, or which is also called as a biotic components, the living component of habitat is called as biotic components. That is, plants and animals. If you see in environment, plants and animals are a living component. So, they all are a biotic environment or component. Another one is a abiotic component. The non-living component of the habitat are called as abiotic component. For example, air, water, soil, rocks are the best example of non-living component. Habitat. Every animal has an habitat. So the place where an animal or a plant live and grow and complete their lifespan, that place is called as habitat. A habitat is where an animal find the food, water, shelter to survive. That is called as habitat of their animal and plants. See here, the ocean, forest, desert, grassland are the examples of the habitat. Now move to the types of habitat. Basically, the habitats are divided into two types, which is terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitat. And further, the terrestrial habitat divided into desert, mountain and grassland habitats, and aquatic habitats are divided into ocean and pond habitat. So we will discuss one by one each and every types. The first one is terrestrial habitat. The plants and animals that live on land are said to live in a terrestrial habitat. For example, the examples of terrestrial habitats are forest, grassland, desert, coastals, and mountain regions are the example of terrestrial habitat, and terrestrial habitat is also called as land habitat. Here is the different types of land habitat and terrestrial habitat. Desert, tundra and rainforest, forest, grasslands are the examples of land habitat. Here also I'm showing you the types of terrestrial habitat: forest, grasslands and deserts. So mountain habitats. In the mountain habitats, rocky lands, snow and icy regions are the main feature of this habitat. Temperature of the mountain change with altitude. In the lower regions are cooler, but at a higher altitude it's extremely icy and cold. There is a trees like pine and fir. Animals like mountain goats and yaks are found in these regions. Like in a desert habitat, vast range of sand, high daytime temperature and low nighttime temperature, very little water, are the main environmental factor of these habitat. Cactus and camels, snakes are the plants and animals which are survive in a desert habitat. Now we will move to the next type, which is aquatic habitat. The habitat of the plants and animals that live in water are called aquatic habitats. The example of aquatic habitats are ponds, lakes, rivers, oceans are the examples. Aquatic habitats could be a fresh water or a marine water or even estuaries. Here you can see the aquatic habitat diagram. We will discuss about the next type of habitat, which is aerial habitat. The habitat located in air is called as aerial habitat. It has the animals that are adapted to move, fly, glide in air. They all live in an aerial habitat. For example, bird, insect, bats are the examples of the aerial habitat. I hope you are able to understand about the habitats and the features of living and non-living thing in this video. Thank you.